Hi everyone, I am Nishtha. Welcome back to our playlist of Udu Education Management System. In our previous video, we introduced the module with a quick overview. Today in this video, let's see how Udu Education Management helps admin efficiently manage attendance, admission, fee management and student records all in one place. So let's get started. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell to stay updated with the latest content. Apart from this, I would like to mention that if you need extensions for increasing the sales of your e-commerce store, then you can visit store.webcool.com and explore a number of products for every technology. We also have the user guide for the same in our blog sections, from where you can check the features and configuration and get to know the functionality of the extensions as well. Now let's move back to our video. Now let's check the workflow. Here you can see we are at the backend, and with the help of email and the password, we're going to log into our admin panel. There we have a unified dashboard from where we can check the total applications, total enrollments, total students and the total faculty. How many are absent and how many are present. All the stats of applications and the enrollments. In the notice board, you can check the latest notification of your school. The next we have scheduled, the classes which are scheduled, class assignment and the student assignment itself. Now first of all, we'll check how we can create the grade scale. So for that, we'll navigate towards the configuration and click on grade scales. Here you can see we have already created the grade scale. For creating a new one, you can just click on new. After entering the details, it will look like this. You can also create the grade scale as per your requirement. After this, we'll create the grades. For that, navigate towards the classes and click on grades. Here we have already created the grades. For creating the new, just click on new option. After you enter the details, it will look like this. Likewise, you can also add the subject, teachers and the grade scale. Next, we'll create the subjects. Navigate towards the subject option. There we have the list of the subjects which we have already created. For creating the new subject, you can click on new and can enter the required details. After entering the subject, you have to click on teachers and navigate towards the teacher so that you can assign teacher for particular subject to the class. For creating a new teacher, you can click on new, and if you want to check any of the existing one, you can just click on the teacher option and can see the information which we have already entered. Now next, we'll create the time slot. For that, navigate towards the configuration and click on time slot. Time slot is basically the time which is allotted to a particular grade for a particular subject. So you can also create a new time slot. Here we have already created few of them. After this, we're going to create the class location where the class will going to held. Here we have already created few of them. Next, we'll create the session. From which session till which session this academic year will work. There you can see we have already created few of them, and you can just click on this start and can start the session. If the session have been completed, you can just click on this complete option as well. Next, we'll navigate towards the academic years. Here we have the list of the academic years. If you want to create a new one, you can just click on new and can create the new academic year. Next, we'll check how the inquiry form will look at our website. So for that, we'll navigate towards the website option. There we have the option of admission inquiry. Click on it. This is our inquiry form. The student will apply from here. And once they submitted the application, it will look like this in our applications list. There you can see, for example, the student have submitted the application. It will look like this to the admin, and the admin can enroll now directly from here by clicking on enroll now. There we have two options. If you want to create a new student, you can go for the new student, and if you want to link to any of the existing students, so you can just click on link to an existing student. Now click on enroll. The student have been enrolled.
Now if you want to start, so just click on start now. Before that, you have to choose the session and the academic year. Now you need to add the subjects and click on start now. And once the session of this particular student completed, you can just click on complete. Or if you want to change anything, you can just click on reset. Next option we have is enrollments. There you can check the list of the students which are already enrolled. You can check the details of the student. And if you want to complete the session of the student, you can just click on complete. The session have been completed. Next, if you want to promote now, just click on promote now. And choose the next grade for the student. And then click on promote now. From here, the student have been promoted. And you can start the new session of the student by clicking on start now. Now next, we'll see how we can create assignment types. Navigating towards the configuration and click on assignment types. Here you can see the assignment type which we have already created. For creating a new one, you can just click on new and can add the details as per the requirement. There you can see the list which we have already created for the assignment type. You can assign the assignment to the students. Next, we navigate towards the classes option and click on populate class. Populate class is basically the classes which will be assigned to the students as per their marks or the grades. For creating a new populate class, you can click on new. There we have already existing populate classes. You can check. If you want to schedule it now, you can just click on schedule now. If you want to assign assignment to this particular grade, so you can just click on assign assignment. And if you want to mark it as done, just click on mark it as done. By clicking on classes, you can see how many classes have been done for this particular subject in this grade. Next, we have class attendance. From here, the admin can manage the attendance for the particular classes. So this is how admin can manage everything from a single portal.
That's how admins can handle school operations with Udoo. Up next, we'll see how teachers can simplify lesson planning, assignments, student performance all in one place. So stay tuned. If you have any question, reach us at support@webpool.com or visit it at webpool.uvdesk.com. See you all in the next one. Till then, thanks for watching.